Nataja, Zanelle here, and welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for deciding to watch this video. Today I'm going to be doing the new YouTuber tag, but really I'm not a new YouTuber. I have been on YouTube for about a year. I've been on YouTube for a year. My year mark was in December. But I haven't posted consistently, so I'm trying to do better with that. And this is my attempt to do that. I'm also trying to revamp my channel. So this will give me a chance to really tell you guys what you can expect from me, who I am. You know, since I have been on here a year, I'm sure my new subscribers, not everybody wants to go back 56 videos to figure out who I am. Yeah, if you want to know more about me and my channel and what's to come, tune in next. All right, let's get into this tag. First up is, what is my name? My name is Nataja Zanelle. That's my first and middle name. That's what I'm known professionally as. My channel originally was Single in the City. Originally, of a guide to dating for virgins. Which I am. I'm waiting for marriage. If you watched any of my videos, then you already got that part. And then I kind of revamped it to a vlog series for hopeless romantics who refuse to give up on the ideal of love because goals. And that's still very much so a part of my channel, what my channel is about for the most part. But I just want to do more. I want to create more content. A bigger variety of content. So I kind of took out the tagline, and I'm only going to use it in videos that have to do with like dating and relationships, because your girl's single and I'm not dating, so I can't create videos about dating if that's not what I'm doing, you know. So yeah, the name of my channel is Nataja Zanelle, which is who I am. Question number two is, oh, and I'm 25. That's not on the list, but I'm 25. I'll be 26 in July. I'm getting old. Question number two was, where am I from? I hail from Chester, Pennsylvania. Love it. Okay. I also lived in Delaware for about the same amount of time that I lived in Chester. So people clown me and they say I'm from Delaware, but I claim Chester. Chester, PA is where I was born and raised. That's my hometown. I currently live in California, which is lit because if you know me, it's something that I've always wanted to do. So being here, living here for a year, it's been amazing. It's been amazing. So I'm blessed to be able to be where I am right now. Question number three is, how tall am I? Because these tags are like, Mishwa. But I'm gonna just go with it. I'm 5'2". I'm really short. If you can believe it, my mom is shorter. Like, I'm taller than my mom. Question number four is, do I have any siblings? I do. I have a big family. I have five brothers. The youngest is 18. The oldest, I think, is 36. I'm bad with numbers. And I have one sister. She'll be 24 this month. I think she'll be 24. Yeah, because my other brother just turned 24. So, yeah, she'll be 24 this month. Very big family. What is my channel about? Which is the reason why I'm doing this tag, because I don't want to confuse anybody. My channel originally was about, it was going to center around dating relationships as a 21st century virgin who was waiting until marriage to have sex. And how hard that process journey is. And just the woes of dating in the 21st century, period. Because we live in a generation where folks, they not really about that dating life. They definitely not about that courting life. So it's very interesting to be someone who thinks so traditionally in a world that's very, very untraditional. We just threw tradition to the wind. We just do what we want nowadays. But that's mainly what it was supposed to be about. I'm single in the city. I was coming to a new city. I thought I wanted to be more social and more outgoing, go on more dates, meet new people. That's not happening. I still want to do that. It's just not happening for whatever reason. So also in real life, I am a fashion designer, a blogger, a poet, and I feel like bits and pieces of that I've shown on my channel. Poetry, definitely. I have a whole playlist of my poems, or some of my poems, but I don't feel like I've really show my full personality on YouTube, which is sucky because I have one. I feel like I have one. And I want to put that up here. So my channel going forward will still be about dating and relationships when it happens, if it happens. But you can expect like DIYs, because I'm a very creative person, very artsy. Poem, like poetry, spoken word, if you're into that kind of thing. Style hauls, style videos, hauls, skits, I like to do kind of like acting monologue type of things. You're just gonna see a very wide variety of videos that really make up who I am as a person, as an artist, as a creative soul. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. I hope you guys tune in and see what's to come next. But that's really what my channel is about. Living this life, this Cali life. And where do I see myself in 5 years? Where do I see my YouTube channel? In 5 years, I will be carried. I'm bad at math. Wait, no, this is bad. Okay. I'll be 31. Am I lying? I'll be 31. In 5 years, I'll be 31. If I have it my way, I'm married. I'm married. 2 kids, because I have my twins, and one on the way, maybe working on number 3. And I know that sounds crazy to most people, but I want 6 kids. Maybe once I start to reproduce and I'll realize maybe I don't, but in my head I want 6 kids. So I will be married. I would 2 girls, please. Please have 2 little girls, Peyton and Paige, and we would be on YouTube. We would be like a whole another YouTube family to follow, vlogging our lives. I don't know that I would be in LA. I don't know that I would still be in California. I don't know that I could be that far away from my mom having kids. I don't know, but I know I'd be married with kids. I would be doing my creative passions full time. I will be self employed, working boss woman, just doing my thiz not ye. Everything else is kind of like subjective. I don't know, but for definite, I would be married with kids. I'd be happy. Not that I'm not happy now, but I'd be happy. And I'd be a working boss woman doing my thiz not ye. That's where I see myself in 31 years. And we will be showcasing it all for you on YouTube. Getting our lives. We look cute little vlog family. I can't wait. What inspired me to do YouTube? Sorry. I've always watched YouTube. I've always liked the ideal of creating videos, being funny, being sarcastic, being creative. I've always loved it. I never thought about starting a channel until I consequently was about to move here. I was like, you're about to move to a new city. I was 24 at the time, I think, when I started. 24 at the time. I was like, you're still single. You're not doing anything about it. Why not make a YouTube channel and, like, follow your journey? Not that this journey has been, you know, eventful thus far, but that's really what started me on doing that. I feel like I have a story and a journey to share, and I feel like there's other people going through it, and none of my friends are abstinent or virgins or waiting. I didn't have any role models to look up to as far as in my real life to kind of like help me along this journey. So I was like, why not check out YouTube? I'm sure there is somebody out in this world that, you know, is going through the same thing I'm going through, feeling the same way that I feel, can relate to me on some level. And I just wanted to build that kind of community so I didn't feel like I was alone all the time. You know what I mean? And it's been a beautiful journey so far as YouTube, not just dating like them. But yeah, that's pretty much what inspired me to do YouTube. Who are my favorite YouTubers? I love YouTube and I always watch it. There's so many, like, there's so many categories of videos that I watch. Who pops to mind? Sabrina Rose. She's a beauty guru on YouTube. She lit. She's the reason why I be, like, beating my face and, like, knowing how to beat my face. Because, like, before, I didn't really fool with makeup because I was like, I can't do it. She's lit. My girl Brianna Marie, she does like lifestyle videos, challenges, beauty videos as well. She's pretty lit. I love her. Josie, I love Josie. Smart brown girl. I love that she creates content that I wouldn't watch from anyone else. Like, I'm not deep into politics. I love history, but I'm not deep into like watching history stuff, but I feel like every time I watch her videos, I come away knowing something that I didn't know before, which is lit. So I love her. I love Jackie Aina. I love It's My Ray Ray. They're two of my favorite like big name beauty gurus. Shameless Maya, Shan Booty. Shan Booty is my inner spirit woman, for real, for real. Like, which is crazy because she talks about sex and I ain't having none, but I just feel like she gets me, you know. Peter McKinnon, he does like photography videos, and I'm trying to up my game with editing and photography and videography and all that. With Wendy, I love her for like design videos. Who else? I can't think of their name. Shoot. The Sorry Girls for like their DIYs. There's somebody else that I watch and I love, and I just can't think of who it is. No. Oh, shoot. How could I forget my girl, Shayina? Shayina B, we actually did a video. We did a drunk makeup no mirror challenge. She does, she kind of does like vlog. She does vlog. What am I saying? She does vlogs, but, you know, we're actually friends and we've been rapping back and forth, and I really feel like we about to go hard with our YouTube channels, and like, watch out for us, is what I'm saying. Watch out for her. She's coming. I love Liza. Who doesn't love Liza? Oh, Amber Scholl. I love Amber Scholl. Sorry, I'm looking at my YouTube. I love Amber Scholl. Her personality is just so over the top and extra, and I love it because it's like who I would be if I didn't care what people thought half the time. And Arnell, I love her. The twin, Arnell Armand. I love Alyssa Ashley too, but Arnell specifically because she does like the hair videos, and I be trying to figure out how to lay my hair. But yeah, they're some of my favorite YouTubers. That's a lot of information, but you're welcome. What is the best thing about YouTube? The best thing is that it's a platform where creatives can come together and create content that you would not see anywhere else. Like, you get to see the beauty and the innovativeness of our generation. Like, people like really be like going hard with their YouTube channels. Like, people are geniuses. Like, I swear, YouTube gives people this platform to be themselves and to create and to fuel their passion, and you get paid for it if you do it well enough and people want to look at you. I think that's awesome. I think that's awesome. The worst thing about YouTube is that it just brings out, at least in the comment section, not my comment section, but in other people's comment section, it just brings out the worst in people. It's like, I've never seen people be so adamant about hating something and having to express that opinion. It's like, if you don't like it, just keep moving on. Like, don't watch the video. Like, I don't understand the idea of disliking a video or leaving a nasty comment. If you look at something and it's not something you're interested in, just move on. Like, you see the worst of people in some people's comments, and it's just like, do I really want to live on earth anymore with these people? Because you're doing the most. But, you know, with social media, period, this, it kind of comes with the territory. Like, there's going to be the people who love you and love on you, and then there's going to be people who hate. and hate on you. Like, it's sad, but it's the truth. So what are my goals when it comes to YouTube? Okay, so I understand that I am in a niche that is not very popular. Okay, so if you're not in like beauty or gaming or, you know, photography or some of these bigger, you know, niches, you're not, not to say you're not, not to say it can't happen, but it's not, you don't, it's not as common to see, you know, certain channels go high in views and numbers because, you know, it's not too many people, as many people checking for that, you know, category of videos. So I do dating relationships. I mean, now that I'm kind of branching out and doing DIYs and more style and those kind of videos, I might be able to, you know, increase my reach. But having thousands, that's a lot. Would I like to have 1 million subscribers? Yeah, that would be cute. But really, my goal for my channel is to inspire and to create visuals that I am proud of, that other people like. Because, I mean, that's always, you know, a plus. And to encourage people on the journey of waiting until they're married, for hopeless romantics who feel like they're in a generation of people who just don't even care about love anymore. Cha. Like, inspire, create, and encourage. That's my goal for my YouTube channel. And if I can get a lot of subscribers and followers, that would be cool. I'm not even going to say I don't. I would love to be able to get that little plaque with the YouTube thing and like put it on my wall. Listen, goals. But my immediate goals is to inspire, to encourage, and to create. Just be out here doing me. You know what I mean? And hopefully people flock to it. Hopefully people relate to it. Hopefully people can get on board with it. You know what I mean? That's my goals. Oh, and to make some money. Because, like, who don't want their coin? Like, any advice for new YouTubers? Be consistent. Because I is not, and it's important. I noticed that when I'm more consistent with uploading videos, I have more engagement. I get more followers or more subscribers. More people get to see my content because I get boosted up. I mean, I get to get to the YouTube watch page, things like that. So consistency, quality. I'm not saying you gotta have the best of the best cameras and the backdrops and, you know, the lighting, which is important. When you get up to that point, you definitely should get it if you can afford it. But quality is making videos that you are proud of, something that other people can, you know, look at and understand, grasp, relate to. So, yeah, consistency, quality, engagement. It's a community. I feel like we're losing the sense of community in YouTube, but it's a community. Get out there and talk to other people. Look at other people's videos. Interact with them, not just so you can get more followers, but because you genuinely care about the content that that person is creating. There are so many niches on YouTube. You can find videos that you like and interact and engage with them. And, yeah, just be yourself. Clearly, you know, that whole cliche everybody else is taking, which is true. I mean, unless you, like, manufacture a whole nother person. But don't do that. Be yourself. Show your personality. Develop some thick skin because you need it out here in these YouTube streets, in these comment streets. Trust me, they get crazy. Yeah, that's pretty much the advice I have for any new YouTubers. Just create the video. Like, I know you, like, want things to be perfect and you go back and forth about whatever. Just create the video. Put it out there. Get yourself going. I feel like my eyelash is flipping up and that's annoying. You know what I mean? Like, that's real life annoying. Okay. Something interesting about me. Hmm. Well, if you haven't watched any of my videos, you wouldn't know, but I've only been on one date. I've only dated one guy in my 25 years of being on this grassy green earth. I've only dated one guy. I date guys. That's my flavor. I don't know. I guess I should put that out there in the universe. Yeah, that's interesting. I miss that whole stay up all into the wee hours in the morning talking to, you know, bae. It wasn't called bae back in the day, but bae in high school, or going to prom with somebody cute. I went to prom by myself with my friends. I missed that whole phase of, you know, puppy love. I didn't get that. So some days I'm kind of like upset that I missed out on that. Not to say that I couldn't have been in a relationship. In high school, middle school, I was pretty much to myself. Like, I worried about my books in my school and what I like to do. I wasn't really checking for nobody. Not to say nobody was checking for me, but I wasn't checking for them. And sometimes I don't know that I regret it, but I do kind of feel like, oh, maybe I should have gave somebody a chance. But it is what it is. Gotta keep going. Three reasons you looking at this video should subscribe to my channel. I got you. Okay. Reason number one, because I'm funny. And that's not just me talking. Like, people have told me that I'm funny, and I believe them. Number two, if you're a hopeless romantic, a poet, a writer, a blogger, a creative, you're going to find something on my channel that you like, because I do so much and I want to put that on my channel. And something is going to, you're going to be able to relate to something. If you watch all my videos and you can't relate to anything I've ever said, hit me up and let me know, because I might give you a dollar. Like, I don't see how that could happen. I'm relatable, I think. Reason number three, because I guarantee you that you will never find anybody on YouTube quite like me. And that's not me being narcissistic, which I couldn't be at times because I'm a Leo. You know, I am one of a kind. I am cut from a different cloth. So I guarantee you that it will be an experience watching one of my videos. An experience that you want to have. Trust me. And if after those three reasons you still don't want to watch my channel, I'm cool with it. Because I only want people here who want to be here. You feel me? You feel me? All right. And to close it all out, what is my favorite video so far on my YouTube channel? Consequently, it's my video where I'm talking about my first date at 24. That was December 2016. I went on my first date and I put it on YouTube because I document my entire life, whether it's YouTube, I have a blog, shameless plug here. Follow me on that. Honestly, if you've ever experienced an experience with me, I might have wrote about it. I might have talked about it. This comes with the territory of dating a writer, a poet, a YouTuber. So yeah, that about wraps up my new, not so new YouTuber tag. I hope you learned something different, something interesting. I hope you want to rock out with me after this video. Don't unsubscribe though. Don't do that. Stay, please. And yeah, I will see you in my next video. Okay, I forgot. Totally forgot. If you're here and you aren't subscribed, do me a favor. Hit that subscribe button. Trust me, you want to stay. You want to join the family. You do. I know you do. If you are subscribed, please hit the notification bell, because I want you to know exactly, precisely, as soon as I upload. So you can check it out, you know what I mean? Because views, boo. And yeah, all my social media links are in the description box below. Check them out. Let me know what you think. Follow me, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat. I got them all, honestly. And yeah, I'll see you in my next video. Bye, YouTube.
Bitch, how do you
see your eyebrows?
I can't. Okay. I can film them though. They're okay. Pretty.
So
they're pretty.
So. you're not even going to admit that she exists. Like, she's out here in the world existing. Like,